Sir, you are telling that if court if court give a right to make a decision on Ram Mandir, you will give this particular Babri Masjid land to Ram Mandir. So what exactly you want to say on this? And you also said that you will be giving a 1 kg of gold brick to Ram Ram temple construction. So what exactly you want to say on this?
Sir, actually I have a filed petition in the Supreme Court of India. Honorable, we have already first we have filed in Bhagpur, and then in 2018 I have a filed petition in Supreme Court of India. Then it was dismissed, and again 2009 we have filed as a title owner. So what the Supreme Court says that because now the case is in last moment, we will not entertain any third party. So my advocates already argued in 5 benches just that we are not third party, we are the affected party, because they three of them don't have the title. Even they failed to provide the documents in Allahabad court, and they came to Supreme Court, and now they are just wasting the time of the Honorable Supreme Court. You know why? Now work board saying that they are getting documents for a scanning. Now Ram Janmabhoomi said that they are saying they are getting, even though from where they will bring the documents, sir? First of all, I will say you that that property belongs to Babur. It will confirm, because the Mandir was built, mask was built in 1529 by Babur's soldier Mir Baqi, and that property was totally for the soldiers, because that time a really desert area was there. So they want to best for the military, they have built this mosque now. So automatically that is a private property. There is no will deed. From where the work board will be building the will deed of Waqf? It's not a Waqf. So Waqf unnecessary wasting time. And Babur is not a grandfather of Waqf. He has to prove that Waqf and Babur has a good blood relation, and then he cannot prove it. Because so that it means that what I am saying, that that property belongs to Babur from 1526 till 1857. It was in Babur Mughal's control from 1857 till 1947. It was in British India, but even though that property nobody has taken, that is still Babur property. Whole India has been taken over, and from 1947 till 2019, Indian government has taken over, but that particular party, they have kept the receiver. So it means that property belongs to Babur. And now Narmoya Khada and this Hindu Mahasabha, from where they will bring the documents? They have to bring the document from last, because 1526 before Ibrahim Lodi was there, and some thousands of years from nobody can, then that they will just pass the time. They will get the benefit, political benefit they will get it. Mullahs will get the income. They will get every debates, and media people will get the TRP. But every day they will have a new debates. And this politician, the people who are last 20 years, 30 years before demolition, they are living in a rented house. They are now living in a thousands of crores house. You just go there. I don't want to say the names. And the mullahs, they are going on the rickshaw cycle. Now they have a big cars they are going, because of this Ram Mandir and Babri Masjid issue. So they are not going to solve. And this, and 100% Supreme Court day by day hearing also, from where they will bring the documents, sir? Supreme
sir,
Court.
It's almost 3 decades that this decision has been continuously on pending. So at the last moment, you came and again you have filed a petition on this, that this land belongs to Babur. So don't you think that again this decision will take time more?
Sir, now
it's decades?
Sir, now going to be very fast. You know why? Day by day hearing also, they cannot be the documents. Even though day by day, you are wasting the time of Supreme Court. From where you, in last 20 years, you have not brought the documents. In 1 or 2 weeks, from where you bring the documents? And Supreme Court clearly said that I will give the decision only on the title. From where they will bring it, sir? Just imagine. Just go and don't, because you are also educated, I am also educated. Just think it, from last 25 years, they have failed in Allahabad High Court, they have failed in Supreme Court, they have wasted the time of Supreme Court for so many years. From 3-4 days or 1 week from there, now Supreme Court will get very easy to get the decision. It's my thing that, because I have a title, let them prove, they give the debate time for 4 months or 6 months. If not failed, then we will hand over to him. Let him give the 1 year time to these three of them. If Supreme Court orders them to bring the time in so much only, because you have taken it last 30 years, no, we will give the time to proceed your title papers within a period of times. Otherwise, we have one title owner is there. It will finish.
Sir, on this decision, the thousands, lakhs of Muslims are against you. On this decision, whatever you have taken on Ram Mandir, that you said that you will give this dispute land to Ram Mandir. So thousands of Muslims are against you, and the many political leaders have criticized you, and many says that you are not belongs to any Mughal empire. There are many comments coming on on this issue. So what do you want to say on that?
See, sir, don't say in India we have 30 CR Muslims. So particularly gamblers, cheaters, they are afraid. They will say against me. And a politician, because they are going to the shop, going to be closed. And I am a Muslim, pure Muslim. I am a first Islamic scholar of India also. So I will affirm with Allah. What I am doing in the on the grounds of what the Prophet Muhammad says, what the Quran says, on that grounds. So 90% Muslims, they know that what I am doing good. Because of 10% or 5% land grabbers, Deshdrohi is there. They are saying. So for that, even the Prophet Muhammad was doing good things. Our prophets, we have a lot of prophets. Saints also, when they do good things, they will get so many type of black remarks. They will get it. Sometimes they will get beaten also. So that is normal in Islam. So I'm not afraid. Allah is with me. And Allah knows that, God knows that what I am doing, I'm not doing for the publicity. Publicity is not enough for me, because every year I'm going to Taj. I will open the doors of Taj. There are total international media is there. Wherever Dubai, if I go, any country though, media was ready there. So for me, media publicity, because they need the cheap media publicity. But you see that Muslim person, that's anchors, they will come for 200 or 300 rupees, they are coming for debate. But alhamdulillah, I'm very happy. So we are not doing for the money, we are not asking for the publicity also, we are doing for the nation, to become a harmony in the country and peace in the country.
Sir, many people says that, means many politicians, it might be scholars, says that you are an agent of BJP and RSS, and BJP, RSS at the back of you. They are asking you to speak all these things. What do you want to say?
Sir, I am the blood of Taimur. Nobody can hire me. He's there. I am a very big follower of my Prime Minister. Should be. As a citizen of India, you have to respect. I know why I am very fan. Because what he has done now, you will see the result after 20 years. So I am an engineer, electrical engineer. I am very highly educated. My children are doctors. We have 35 doctors in our family. So we are seeing what, but these people are not seeing. And it's not nothing in the fundamental right that you cannot love to your Prime Minister, you cannot love to somebody. It's not a thing is there, no? Since my rights is there, I like reminding the BJP, RSS people, this is if you are living in the world, you have to meet it. I met with Indiresh Kumarji, when he say hello, hi and hi, it's not an agent. I met with Bhaiyaji Joshi, I met with Rajnath Singh, sometimes I went there, invitations, I met him, it's not anything wrong. I didn't join the BJP, but even though I respect my Prime Minister, but the leaders, even I met with the Rahul Gandhi PA also. I went with Sushma. Sheila Dixit, personally I met him before 2 months back. So I am an agent of the Sushma Congress. She invited me to her house. She has invited me tea and coffee. I met him. I was waited for 25 minutes. Before dying, three, four months I was there. And I was in Sonia Gandhi house also. That the PA, he called me there on the day. So I am a boy of Congress. I met Mulayam Singh also in his villa.
No, sir, particularly.
What his name is UP Mayawati. I met with Mayawati also. Recently, when I met with Sheila Dixit, the same day I met with Mayawati also. I am a boy of Mayawati. See, I am doing for the nation, sir. I don't bother what the people says. And they cannot change my mind also. Whatever they are using vulgar language to me, they are threatening me, they are showing knives. These people of Hyderabad, they are showing knives, they are using very bad language. I don't see God is there, sir. When the times come, then only you die. So I will not afraid with these small peanuts and small leaders of the street leaders. I will not afraid. But my action is same. I will do it once the Honorable Court give me the chance, at least one hearing, just give, then we'll show the documents.
Thank you so much, Mr.
My pleasure, sir.